Hey guys, what's up? My name is Anthony, and welcome to another edition of BNA Sports Talk. And I try to warn you, everybody, a bunch of people are like, oh yeah, the Giants are going to win, don't worry. I said we might be riding a little bit high. Leonard Williams, Defensive Player of the Week. You had, you know, Coach Judge, and I enjoy the hype, you know, because I'm a Giants fan. I knew it wasn't going to last long, and, you know, I enjoy it while it lasts. And I'm not saying the season's over, but Daniel Jones is injured again, and we kind of know the season's a little bit over. Yesterday was not a good day. The NFC East went 3-1. We were the only loss. You know, even the Eagles won against the New Orleans Saints with Jalen Hurts. You know, the Cowboys destroyed the Bengals. Washington lost in the stats against the 49ers, but they were 3-point underdogs. We were 3-point underdogs. So, you know, they did what they had to do. And I want to talk a little bit about Chase Young, because I may get into this a little bit more in the offseason, but a bunch of people are like, oh, we should have tanked for Chase Young. And, you know, obviously, Chase Young right now is a better player than Andrew Thomas. But let me tell you, what would we be doing right now at offensive line if it wasn't for Andrew Thomas? Nate Solder opted out, so we would have Matt Parrott at left tackle. And then, or maybe we drafted a second-round offensive lineman, or what we'd have gone after. And Austin Jackson was already taken. We would have gone after a Josh Jones, what's that guy from Boise State? I forgot his name. You know, one of those guys. And Daniel Jones would have just been running for his life, and he would have been even more injured. As far as how he played decently. It's just some plays he just has a bad look. Hassan Reddick is a good player. I wanted him on the Giants before the season started. And by the way, I watched the highlights again. Was Isaiah Simmons playing? I didn't even notice him at all. But as far as Marcus Golden, I said he may have some tricks against Andrew Thomas. He may have some tells, like, hey guys, this is what you have to do against Andrew Thomas. Andrew Thomas leaned on some plays, but he's physical, he's big, and I don't think we learned anything new about Andrew Thomas. We know some plays he's going to look really bad. He's a pretty good run blocker, 9th in the league in run block win rate, and that's how we want to win. We want to win by running, but nowadays it's a passing league. We're transferring into a little bit more of a passing league. Big Online Blue Sports Entertainment said it right. Daniel Jones, any single play, even saw break it down last year. Daniel Jones makes one read. Okay, this guy, the safety's over here. Maybe move him with your eyes a little bit and then toss it to this guy. He doesn't do anything complex. Now, he's from Duke. He's a smart kid. Can he develop and learn a couple more things? Maybe. You know, Patrick Mahomes, we all know, he just started to learn how to read defenses in his third year. The thing about Patrick Mahomes is he was making sick plays. I think it was irresponsible for the Giants to put Daniel Jones in yesterday with the play calling that they had. I said, if Daniel Jones is healthy, you play him, obviously, and you don't change your play calling. But he obviously wasn't healthy, 100%. So you have to, why don't we run the ball? You know, Wayne Gallman was getting 5 yards a carry. I would have just had the rotation, just try to put it down their throats. Maybe they saw something I didn't. I'm not saying I'm a professional. But, you know, obviously I'm not getting paid for this, but I thought the Giants was a mess as far as the whole grand scheme of things. Honestly, what was the expectation going into this year? What did we say the Giants were going to be? We said there were a 5-11, 6-10 team. They're 5-8. And we had some impressive wins. We also had some games we should have won. You know, we're exceeding expectations so far this year. And if we end up going 5-11, I'd say it's a little bit of a disappointing season. 6-10, you could be like, meh, 7-9. But yeah, this was a pretty good season. I'm excited to see what the Browns do tonight, whether, you know, we could steal a game against the Browns. Obviously, we're probably going to roll out Colt McCoy next week. Were you expecting to win the Super Bowl this year? No. And I trust this coaching staff to make some more moves in the future to make this team successful. And that's where I'm at this point. As far as the actual game, you probably heard 50 million people talk about the specifics of the game. I really don't want to get into it. This year we added to our depth. Next year, we need to add to our talent. Get the high-end talented people. We'll discuss more about the draft later. But as far as defensive ends that we can bring in, we brought in Jabal Sheard, who's looked pretty good. Bring in a Solomon Thomas. He's coming off an ACL, so maybe, you know, with the kind of like the with the Ryan Connolly thing, maybe Solomon Thomas. He played with Blake Martinez, so he could he can find a little bit of a home here, because what we know is that Solomon Thomas had a little bit of a family issue, like the friend, I think the sister died or something. So he needs a change of scenery. Maybe bring him in, because he's a former first-round pick. I think that could be somebody you could look forward to. But as far as I was looking at some other names, there's some old pass rushers like a Justin Houston. I don't want to bring any of those guys in, because we already have those guys. Dalvin Tomlinson, I'm really mixed on. Some days I'm like, I don't want him. But here's the thing. His value on the market's $9.5 million. I searched up Leonard Williams' value on the market. It's like $8 million. And I think the team kind of knows this. So in my opinion, what the Giants are going to do at this point is I don't think that we're going to re-sign Leonard Williams. I'm leaning towards we're not re-signing Leonard Williams right now. And maybe we tag and trade him or do something like that. But I really don't think that we would do that. You know, Dave Gettleman, he traded a third and a fifth for Leonard Williams, a third and a fourth, I think, this year, if we sign him to a long-term extension. But I think we almost have to let our ties go with Leonard Williams. Have, you know, Dalvin Thomas with Dalvin Thomas and Dexter Lawrence on that defensive line, keep on drafting defensive tackle talent. But we need a guy on the edge that can just win. You know, and Chase Young, that's what he does. That's what he does. I think he's going to get better over the years. Okay, now here is your 30-second draft preview of Gregory Rousseau. So, he's 6'6". I think he can add a little bit more size to himself. He does a lot of shoestring tackles. He's very lengthy. He can, you know, just a really good run stopper. I don't think he has an elite bend around the edge, but I think it may seem a little bit more natural in the NFL when you have guys that are bigger size. Overall, it would help to be a little bit higher, so we have higher odds of selecting him. There are a bunch of teams that are going to be looking after a guy like this. He didn't play this entire season, but it'd be interesting to see what he could add to this team, because he's also played a little bit of defensive tackle. And the Giants have passed on a bunch of guys like Josh Allen. No, that was for Daniel Jones, our future quarterback, but we've passed on that elite edge guy. We have, obviously, O'Shane and Lorenzo Carter coming back. So that's kind of like you hope that's a solution, bringing another guy. Jadeveon Clowney, could Patrick Graham make Jadeveon Clowney look good like the first overall pick he is? I'm not sure. He's been dealing with a bunch of injuries over the past couple years. He feels like a little bit of a damaged asset, but I'm still leaving Solomon Thomas. He's versatile. He's that guy, but do we have enough of those guys? Do we really just need a guy who has a bunch of bend that can get around the edge? And I think it really does depend on O'Shane and Carter's development, because those are two guys that could do it. Obviously, we have to make decisions. And the bottom line is we have good coaching, so whatever we do, we're going to be able to coach guys up, and they'll be able to look somewhat competent, even though they may not be. But hope you guys did enjoy this video. Let me know what you guys think, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.